It looks like I have to serialize this class. I'll create a function and save the fields one by one in a JSON file. It took a while, and the code is pretty repetitive, but it is finally over and we can check whether it works or not. There it is, the JSON prints out nicely. Let's move on to my next tasks. Oh, it looks like I have to serialize these classes. Will I really have to write the same repetitive code for each one of them? I wonder if there's a more dynamic way. Of course, I can use reflection. Even though C++ doesn't have it natively, I can look for a library that will do it for me. Let's get rid of all of this chunky code now. This one looks good. The documentation even points out how reflection is really useful when we want to serialize in C++. Now that I have read the documentation, I'm ready to set it up in my project. I need to copy-paste the mirror.x file and the config.json file into my project. I also need to configure the tool. I'll set the input directory to where my header files are contained. I also need to create the output directory if it doesn't exist. Finally, I'll tell Mirror which classes I need to reflect. Everything is set up. I sure hope it works. Great! My files have been generated! After I include the reflection files into my project, I'll be able to start coding. I need to create a function that will iterate over the fields of any of my objects. I need to treat them differently depending on them being an integer, a boolean, a character, or another object. I have already coded the function. It won't handle all the possible cases, but it will do for this specific project. Now, I can use the same function for all of my objects, regardless of their type. There it is! I have been able to dynamically serialize all of my objects thanks to Mirror and the power of reflection, and I didn't even have to modify the source code in the slide list. What else could I achieve with this tool?